Yeah, we have no.
So please welcome Sisco Escudero from La Salle Engineering School in Barcelona, and enjoy the talk.
Thank you very much. Well, La Salle Engineering School is 50 years old engineering school, and recently, as a part of our technology transfer activity, we developed and a special methodology dedicated to programming in a multitask environment without no operating system, in order to program and to use a hardware independent based on a little microcontrollers. Microchip, Atmel, and Texas Instruments, 8 bits to 16 bits microcontrollers. The aim is to deal with that problem. Imagine a robot. A robot is the perfect example of a control system. In a robot, we have to deal with a lot of tasks simultaneously. For example, we have to send some type of energy to the motors. We have to control servos. We have to attend maybe sometimes to a keyboard. We have to refresh a display. We have to catch up information about digital sensors and analog sensors. And these analog sensors needs to be filtering. Well, all this is related because digital sensors making ranging or maybe calculating position and so on, digital sensor and analog sensors involves the activity of servos and the actuators, all of them simultaneously, all of them based as well in a controller strategy and a path manager. Don't forget a remote control. And a remote control means a protocol, and a protocol means timeouts, waiting, and so on. Well, how do we do all these tasks? Well, it's easy. If we have an operating system beneath, underneath, the operating system allows us just to program as a thread for every single task. So you launch a thread for the display, another thread for the keyboard, another for the motors, etc. But we have only one processor. Well, doesn't matter. The operating system has a time periodical interrupt called dispatcher. Dispatcher interrupts one task, one thread, interrupts, saves the context, and jumps and switches to another task. For example, interrupt display thread, save the state, and change to keyboard. And then let it run for a while, maybe 5 milliseconds, and once again interrupt and change. Motor, servos, actuators. The idea is the programmer thinks as is a dedicated microprocessor microprocessor is dedicated to every single task. One for the display, one for the keyboard, one for the motors. And the programmer thinks only if they are on problem. When I am programming about the display, I think only in the display. When I am dealing with the keyboard, I only think on the keyboard. Well, but what happens when we have not an operating system? What happens when our microcontroller is so small that we cannot waste the space of RAM and we cannot wait the space of time to put an operating system? Well, we change our mind and we switch to a cooperative approach. Here, and at the left side of the screen, we have a multitask programming of one thread. I mean, this thread is dedicated to one single task, for example, the keyboard. Well, as a normal programming, a standard programming, you just make an eternal loop, this four, and then wait making an eternal while for something that happens and something that we say in event one. For example, the variable event one becomes to one. And we just wait here, independent of what happens with the rest of the system, what happens with the whole of the system. It doesn't matter. We just concentrate on that thread. Well, this is a multitask programming. In a cooperative programming, in a cooperative approach, you change and you think on states. Motors means state machines. In the state number zero, we evaluate the condition that the event one becomes to one, and then we'll change the state. But, well, it's just thinking on a state. This state one, state two, state three. But where is the loop? I mean, we have a loop here, doing waiting, while. Where is the loop? The loop, the only one loop, will be here. Will be here. In the main function, it's a C programming language, in the main function, the only one loop in our system, this one. This loop calls motor one, motor two, motor three, and motor four, and once again, and eternally, in an endless operation. Let me put an example. Imagine at the beginning of the time, the event one variable is zero, and the state of the cooperative of our cooperative motor is zero. Well, let's run the system, and the system begins. Call motor one, jump to motor one, state zero. Evaluate the event one variable and is zero, so nothing happens. Break the end of the motor, main loop, once again. Motor one, motor two, three, four. Case one, case zero, event one is not raised. At the end, and wait a minute. Imagine that at this moment, just at this moment, the external hardware event one rises. The event one that we are waiting for occurs. Well, we have connect the, sorry, we have connect the hardware event, event one, we have connect on a special routine that we call interrupt service routine. This piece of code enters whenever or whatever the hardware rises its information. And this interrupt service routine just enters, put a one value to the event one variable and returns wherever or whenever it has been called. And the main loop continues. Once again, state zero, evaluate. Now we evaluate that even one, that variable that is a mirror of the external hardware event, is one, is not zero. Then we change the state. So now, in the future, for the future, the variable state is now one. And we do something, or we do whatever we want to do, according or coordinate to the rising of the event one, jump, and continue our cooperative system, one. But now, be careful, the next entering to our motor is not case zero, is case one. We have changed our state. We have changed our state, and keep in mind that states are the natural is the natural of a system control. It's just to be in his state to another state and to change to another state. Our motors, the main operation of a motor is evaluate a condition. Well, it's quite difficult to think on programming directly in C. I prefer to use a graphical representation like that, and a graphical representation that is an exact representation of C code. For example, we have the transition to zero, from the state zero to a state one, occurs when the even one variable is not zero. This is the condition for changing. And when we change, we execute. Well, as I said, the main operation of a motor is just evaluating a condition. It's just evaluating a condition and execute something when the condition occurs. Hi, Konstantin. A lot of power. Excellent. Thank you very much. Hi, Nervor. Gary Beaton. Well, more generically spoken, a graphical representation can be like that, from, for example, changing from 6 to 7 in C language is if condition for change occurs, then the next one will be state number 7 and do actions during transition. And we write in that manner, and we use a special tool in order to program that, in order to think, in order to get a pencil and a paper and think and discuss them with your friends and so on. Let me continue. Well, for now, we have introduced the cooperative approach, and we know how to do a lot of things more or less or with the appearance of simultaneously. Well, but what happened with times? Control systems need to wait for time. For example, protocols need to wait for timeout. For example, keyboards need to wait for the bounce. For example, analog signals need to wait for sampling time. How can we do this past timing? How can we go control the time? Well, this is our approach. The time strategy is based on an abstract data type that we call timer. This abstract data time encapsulates the service for monitoring up to 16, no more than 16 timers, different timers. Well, only one tick interrupt in the whole system. Only one tick interrupt service. Our concern, let me say that our concern on interrupts is because interrupts are very dangerous pieces of code. Because interrupts enters whenever they want. So it's difficult to program thinking of that pieces of code enters when they want. So we need to reduce and we need to tight control the interrupt service routine. Well, so I said that only one tick interrupt service routine that will enter typically a 1 millisecond, and we call that a tick. Then motors reset the timer and continuously pulling, waiting for the pass of time. Each motor handles the hour timers thanks to a special methods like get timer and release timer for that is service for the timer IDT. This graphical shows or intends to show what I will do. Let me. I prefer this one. Well, at the left part of the screen, a hardware timer rises an interrupt every 1 millisecond, and this interrupt rises an interrupt service routine timer that increments the whole array of ticks. Two variables, two routines, are called from the cooperative world of our application. And the cooperative world reset a timer and then continuously asking for the pass, asking for get ticks. It's maybe it's a non-optimal approach, but keep in mind that motors always are waiting for a condition. So, if we want to wait sometimes for something, this is the example, this is the procedure. First of all, at the beginning of our motors, we pick a timer and remains in our mind the timer T in order to be different for every motor. Then, when we want to start the timing, we do a reset ticks, and then from the 2 to 3 state, the condition to change is that get ticks gets the value of 10. Remember, at the beginning, reset 0. We go out from the motor, main loop, and enter the motor, and out and in and out and in, motor, main, in, out, etc. Well, a lot of times we will go into the motor and jump to state 2 and asking for get ticks. After 10 milliseconds, the interrupt service routine, we will have been entered 10 times, 10 milliseconds, 10 times. And then finally, we got that get ticks returns true. The condition that get ticks is more or equal than 10 becomes true. And then we do the action that we want to do after 10 milliseconds. It is not precise. It is not exact, because it depends on the activity of the other motors. But it doesn't matter. It's an approximation. But keep in mind that the 99% of actions are not so critical in times. So we can accept some kind of some amount of inexactity, of an accuracy. I will talk about the accuracy later. Well, so we have got the cooperative approach, the time controlling based on reset and pulling, and now interrupt strategy. Once again, an iterative concern. Our interrupt strategy is that all hardware events that cannot get lost, only one, the hardware events that cannot get lost, will connect this hardware event to an interrupt service routine, right? And then, all interrupt service routine in our system will avoid hard or heavy computation. Our service routine only enters, save the information, and returns as soon as possible, and never put heavy functions in an interrupt service routine. I have no time enough to explain that, but believe me, forget it. And be careful about print formatting, and be careful about floating point operations. For example, our interrupt strategy, when we have an edge or byte event, more usual like encoders or similars, then I propose just a connect the hardware edge and rise and interrupt service routine that put a 1 to a flag. This is the interruptive, this is the concurrent war. This is the asynchronous war. And the cooperative motors, the cooperative war in the other side, just enter, I don't know when, just enter and ask for this edge have rise or not. Look at the C code. The destructive reading means that we get the information and put a 0. So it's self-destroying, but it does not the problem because motors remember their state, because motors are able to remember that the variable arises. analog signals have to be sampled at constant period, and after we will process digital processing and filtering and so on. Well, once again, the interrupt service routine only gets the information and save it. Never will do processing in interrupt service routine. I propose that the analog to digital converter at the left side just writes an interrupt every time that he has converted an sample. The interrupt service routine gets the information sampled and put in a queue and a FIFO, and then returns quickly. The cooperative motors, when they want, asking for get data, for data available and get data. That's the reason, or that's the, with using this strategy allows us to separate the cooperative world with the, separate the cooperative motors to the concurrent activity of the converter, of the conversion. Let me repeat. Analog information need to be sampled at constant time. Our processing time, our processing world, we don't know when or where we can get this information. So, in this case, the interrupt service routine put this information on a FIFO and gets out, right? Well, so far we have interrupt service routine strategy. So far we have control, we have multi-threading simulating, but now, let me talk about what happens when we have timing requirements that doesn't allow an error. I mean, what happens when we have a requirement that says, well, the distance in time between this event to this action needs to be accurately defined. What happens if, for example, well, let me say after. What happens if, for example, the requirements say that if the detector P detects an object 100 milliseconds after with an error less than 1 millisecond, we need to activate a relay. We need to activate something. Well, in our approach, this is not possible. The approach based on the reset and get, it is not possible to accurate that because the rest of the motors can waste a pass of time and doesn't allow us to assure that. Well, our methodology obviously need to deal with this kind of signals. Let me say that it is not usual that such a kind of requirements is not usual. Well, our proposal. All part of pair of event and action that require a maximum time error then will be managed always by interrupt service routines. No argue about that, no discussion about that. Only interrupt service routine allow us to define the maximum error time between an event and an action. Celebrate that, let me define an interrupt service routine special that we call scheduler. The scheduler is launched at constant period. It's launched, let's say, for example, every 1 millisecond. It's a kind of dispatcher, but it is not the same. This scheduler is a little silly. It's not a smart processor. The scheduler just look an array of actions and obey the commands right in this array. The array of actions is managed as a circular buffer. The array of actions is have to be large enough to save the maximum future time to be remembered, to be saved. here we have the proposal, the diagram of our proposal. As example, as I said, we got a sensor P that detects presence of object or something. And after a presence is detected, P, then we need to activate a relay 100 milliseconds after this presence, and only during 10 milliseconds. And the requirement says that only 1 millisecond of error is allowed. Keep in mind that we have a lot of motors running, more or less in parallel. Keep in mind that we have to control the display, we have to control keyboard, motors, etc., etc. And we have to assure this restriction. Well, a proposal. The interrupt service routine associated to the event of rising P sensor reads the present variable. The present variable is the most important part of our system. The present is the present, is now, and is increment every single millisecond. 1, 2, 3. So ISR for P reads the present and fills the array of actions for the future. The scheduler every milliseconds enter and read now. What I have to do now? Put a zero on the relay or not? In our example, we have only two conditions: activate the relay or not activate the relay. Well, the future is infinite, right? The amount of RAM of our microcontroller are not infinite. How can we convert an infinite line to a finite structure? Obviously, a circle. A circle is endless. How can we convert a linear array to a circular array? Easy. Because of using the operator modulus. The operator modulus is the best operator in the world, and very used as well in protocols and Windows and so on. Well, for example, take a look at the ISR routine of related or connected to the sensor P. Well, the interrupt service routine enter and fills the array actions on the future, and getting the variable present, that is now plus 100, then we'll put 10 ones to the future. Well, the future is a circle, and look at the operator modulus with max future. In the drawing, we can see that, for example, if present is 160 plus 100 means 260. But if max future is 200, then the result is 60. Look at it. So, the strategy is that, I just repeat, at present plus the future, we fill the future with the actions. In this case, activate the relay or not activate the relay, 0 or 1. And then the scheduler, as I said, no such a smart procedure. The scheduler just read what to do. The ISR for a scheduler that enters every 1 milliseconds, get the actions cell for the present and put it to a relay. Activate or deactivate the relay. Now. And then I put a zero to the cell of actions, now the present, in order to reuse for the circle strategy, to reuse in the future. And just increment present. Present equal max future, then present is zero, that is a circular buffer. Well, Maybe most of you are thinking that of what such a complicated structure just for raising a relay. Well, keep in mind that this is an example, and keep in mind that this is a methodology. And keep in mind that every cell of the array can hold 8. If we define as a character, it can hold 8 commands concentrated in this structure. This is our concept, to concentrate and to control the interrupt service routine of the whole system. Yeah? Well, so every bit, as I said, so thanks to this structure, we can control up to 16 pairs of action, reaction, of event actions. Yes?
Yes.
It works. Oof. Well, I am finished. It is worth mentioning that neither Windows nor Linux are able to control the time as we control. They are not supposed to be so tight controlling for event and reaction. Well, but this is our challenge. As a conclusion, let me say that we get a methodology that is based on state machines, that these state machines are cooperative. That means that you have to change your mind in order to think that we are not alone. Well, we are not alone, but we have not to worry about the rest of the system when you are concentrated programming one single task. The states is the natural behavior of the system. Every system has an state and is waiting for a condition to change to another state. So programming thinking on states is better when you program control systems. Timing based, the strategy of timing is based on reset and pulling. Reset and pulling. This is not so usual, I know. Well, interrupts are small pieces of code which never will do a difficult hardware, and just remember some things that occurs and are connected only to a hardware that cannot be lost. Finally, we dedicate the interruptive scheduler for time register, time restricted event reaction pairs, only for time restricted event reaction pairs. And that's all. Well, feel free to access this page if you want to download a free tool that allows you to draw the state machines and to generate automatically the source code for the every state machine that you define. And that's all. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Any questions? No questions?
For what kind of hardware is this methodology recommended?
Well, this methodology is intended for small microcontrollers. Small microcontrollers with no, let me say, a maximum of 64 keys of RAM, maybe less. Because if you have a microcontroller of more powerful like that, it is better to get a real-time operating system. Well, if you have not a powerful amount of memory, then it's time to forget any operating system from the market, and just it's time for this methodology.
Oh.
which languages does Bubble Wizard support as export?
Is C programming language.
But the cooperative system control variable all the time. It's not slow. The cooperative system control variable all the time. Isn't slow?
Well, if I will understand. Let me say that there is no operating system, no cooperative system that control the time. No, it's just an interrupt service routine connected to a timer that increments the times, the ticks, increments an array of ticks. That's all. No operating system, no other support. Right?
Thank you.